Today's obituaries are brought to you by Moss Service and Hansville Funeral Home. Wilma D. Mayo, age 88, passed away Monday at her residence. Funeral services will be at 11 a.m. tomorrow at Moss Service Funeral Home Chapel. Chris Mayo will officiate interment in Cullman City Cemetery. Those are our obituaries for today, brought to you by Moss Service and Hansville Funeral Home.
At Premier Bank, we're a bit old-fashioned. We actually answer the telephone when you call. However, old-fashioned doesn't mean we aren't up to date. With the latest technology, Premier Bank meets the various needs of our customers. Mobile smartphone banking, internet banking, ATMs, convenient offices. At Premier Bank, we have the right products right now with good old-fashioned customer service. At Premier Bank, we put the customer first.
Life lived in black and white is not a life lived. Today, I choose color. To see it. To feel it. To be in it. To be upon it. And to live a life surrounded by it. Today, I put on a fresh coat.
I believe it is an honor and a privilege to be the sheriff of Cullman County, not a right. And as that honor and privilege, I believe it is the job of the sheriff to serve the needs of the people. It is not the people's job to serve the needs of the sheriff. I can make you this promise. I will lead the sheriff's office with honor, commitment, and integrity to every citizen of Cullman County. I would like to ask for each one of you your support and your vote on June 3rd in the 2014 primary election.
Presents today on 2. We are broadcasting live on Charter Cable. We are broadcasting live on the internet, channelhoopcullman.com. And when the program's over, we archive everything on YouTube. You can follow us on Twitter and on Facebook. Well, let's see. Are we going to get a stormy day today?
I don't know, but it stormed last night. Got good rain last night.
Good rain last night.
Yes, we
and
did.
Storm we activity it. On the way, they
okay.
say. Possibility. One of those big fronts that's going.
Oh, that we watched on the radar
all the way,
yesterday.
Yeah, all the way through the country, something like that.
Okay.
Let's check the weather. Brought to you by Mitch Smith Chevrolet on Cherokee Avenue. We start with the Weather Almanac for the 14th day of May. The average high temperature is 83 in Cullman, Alabama. The average low is 61. The record high on this date, 96 in 1941. And the record low, 41 in 1954. Sunset will be at 7:47. Sunrise tomorrow at 5:41. There's the satellite picture, and you can see the storm front all the way from Texas up to Indiana, maybe into Michigan. And hopefully heading more northeast than east. There you can see a little bit of it right now coming across the southeast. And here's our forecast for today. We can expect a 70% chance of showers and thunderstorms, maybe some severe storms this afternoon. So pay attention to what's going on today. High near 75 for tonight, 80% chance. Showers and thunderstorms, maybe severe storms tonight. Low around 51. And then tomorrow things will start to clear up. Slight chance of rain in the morning with a high of 63. Wow, 83 yesterday, 63. By tomorrow, Friday 66, Saturday 71, Sunday 70. Monday 78, so some interesting weather for the next few days.
Well, it's still that spring, summer, that collision where the warm hits the cold and stuff
you
like
know,
that.
Isn't this weird? We talked the other day, tornadoes in the Midwest, mm-hmm. snow in Colorado, maybe tornadoes in the South. What in the world is going on?
Well, it's
springtime weather, I guess. That's
I think it.
Unstable things.
Definitely.
Well, there we have another political forum for today. This is our second in a series of six, and we will have the candidates today for Associate Commissioner, Place 1, East Side.
Okay.
And that is Darrell Hicks and Kerry Watson.
Very good.
We are guests today, and they will be have questions asked by Philip Hicks.
Right.
And that'll be coming up in just a little bit. How about our Facebook friend?
Let's take a look.
We have a friend for today.
Let's see who our friend is.
There we go.
Larry Duke. And Larry Duke likes Daystar Church and the Brandon Iron. So good for him. Well, we're going to give him some barbecue, but it's going to be from Mad Dog Mike's Famous Barbecue. And, of course, he's going to win a large barbecue sandwich. Just needs to come by here first to pick up that certificate. So, all right, Larry, thanks for being our friend today.
Okay. Coming up next, we'll look at our Know Your Merchant ads and be ready to have the quiz tomorrow.
That's right.
So we'll give you a preview of the ads today. Stay tuned.
In the nation, we reward safe driving. Add Vanishing Deductible from Nationwide Insurance and get $100 off every year of safe driving, which means you could save a lot of Benjamins. We put members first because we don't have shareholders. Join the nation.
Nationwide is on your side.
One of the most frequently asked questions I receive out on the campaign trail is, why do you want to be the sheriff of Cullman County? Cullman County is my home. It's where I was born and raised, and it's where my wife Susie and I will raise our two boys. And there's nothing more important to me than my Lord and Savior, my family, and my home. And I would like to ask for your vote on June 3rd in the 2014 Republican primary election.
We continue with more of Today on 2. As I mentioned, we don't have a quiz for today, but we do want you to see the ads so you're prepared for tomorrow's program when we will have some prizes to give away. So let's look at our merchant ads for today. Starting with Hansville Drugstore, Blast from the Past. And, of course, they have the old-fashioned soda fountain at Hansville Drug.
Loretta can do highlights and haircuts and manicures, pedicures, and waxings. New clients get $5 off. And, of course, go ahead.
Earl Body Shop, celebrating 50 years in business. Large or small towing, local or long distance on Highway 31 North. That's Earl Body Shop.
Mr. Hicks Menswear, formal wear available for all occasions, located right there on Compass Way.
We're in a hurry to get these done
today. I think
we
are.
Mad Dog Mike's Famous Barbecue, $13.99, and you get a full pound of barbecue, two sides and four buns, and the Berwyn Quick Stop.
Constate Barnes of Cullman, buy or rent to own, carports, playsets, utility trailers, storage buildings, no credit check, you're approved, located right there on Highway 278 West, just past I-65. Cotton State Barns of Cullman.
I think what happened is we oiled the computer, you know, it's been running slow, put a little oil, or W-340, now it's fired up and going. Right. Strawberry Shortcake is the Blizzard of the Month, the Dairy Queen.
And B-Fit, a great new fitness facility in downtown Cullman, right next to Renard's Gallery, located on First Avenue. $50 a month, month-to-month, no contracts, and it includes a personal trainer.
Yates Chance Christian Bookstore has the engraving machine.
Pizza Hut! Whoa, that's real quickly! Tires for Less.
What's the one we missed? Company?
It was Pizza Hut.
Pizza Hut. Okay.
Yeah.
Tires for Less. Go, go, come on.
Man.
There we go.
The computer's just acting
all
crazy
right
today. Wants to see how fast we can go.
Okay, no more coffee for the computer. Okay.
Speed readers. That's
we're
what we are.
Watch Money Matters, brought to you by Premier Bank. And then we'll see if we can show you some more ads.
Hi, my name is Brianna Morgan. I would like to talk to you on the importance of naming a beneficiary on your IRA. This makes things a lot easier on your loved ones in the event of a tragedy. Having someone named as beneficiary eliminates any confusion on how the money is dispersed. This has been another helpful hint from Money Matters presented by Premier Bank.
Okay, we will continue with more merchant ads with the same computer.
Oh boy.
All right.
Are you ready? Set, go.
Let's see what we can do. Who are we going to start with this time? Auto Tech Repair and Service. I don't know whether to read these really fast or read these really slow. This is going to be read these really slow. Transmission repair, brake repair.
All right, Jolly Time Rentals, where fun is always in the air. Call Holly Mullins today, 256-620-JOLLY. Licensed inflatables, slides, water slides, obstacle courses, toddler interactives, you name it, Jolly Time Rentals has it.
Grand Point Pharmacy, open at 7:30 each day, Monday through Saturday. They're on Highway 31 North. They have your allergy products. Boy, people are suffering the last few days with all the pollen in the air.
Definitely. Deb's Bookstore. It's your hometown bookstore just down the road, where browsers are always welcome. Gift certificates are available. Used books are half price off every day. New books are 20% off every day at Deb's Bookstore.
The Candle Garden has hand-poured candles in over 50 fragrances, lots of gift items. They can custom make gift baskets for you. They're located right downtown by Moe's Barbecue.
And Mullins Body Shop, you've counted on them for over 50 years for auto body repair and for towing, and you can continue to count on them today. Call Sunny, Stacy, Beth, or Jim.
Fitness opportunities galore at the Wellness and Aquatic Center. They have the full fitness center, they have the indoor pool, the indoor walking track, lots of aerobic and cycling and Zumba classes at the Wellness and Aquatic Center.
And there's Brown & Company right next to the Ford dealership. A huge variety of domestic imports, regional and local beers and wines, ciders, meads, mixes, and gourmet sodas. I'd like to try some of those gourmet sodas. Brown & Company beverages.
Alabama Sunrooms and Awnings. Sunrooms and screen rooms. And of course, they have patio and deck covers, awnings, metal roofs, vinyl siding, garages, and buildings. Free estimates. If they do it, it's built right. There we go with the merchant. And after this commercial break, we'll be back and look at community billboards, birthdays, and the weather.
I will rebuild the relationships with local city, county, and governmental agencies in which we all have the same mindset that we are working together for the betterment of our community in that one single direction for every citizen of Cullman County. My office will be held accountable from the top down. I will be held accountable first. And as your sheriff, I will leave the sheriff's office with conviction, pledging to return the office of sheriff back to the people.
At Premier Bank, we are very proud of the long-lasting relationships we have with our customers. Go almost anywhere to meet your banking needs.
Over
overwhelmed by home refinancing offers from telephone solicitors and direct mail advertising, and then find you're not qualified for a specific plan? The Mortgage Center, a hometown lender, compares the rates from all home loan lenders and the qualifications of the various government programs to find a plan best suited to you. The Mortgage Center helps Cullman County people purchase and refinance their homes.
This is Pat Moody. Call us today and let us tailor a loan program to your specific needs and requirements.
Meet the KitchenAid 36-inch induction cooktop. It might just change the way you cook. Induction technology heats the pan and not the cooking surface to offer you a new level of precision, speed, and energy efficiency. 9 settings give you different levels of heat to achieve precise temperatures and amazing responsiveness. Water boils in just seconds, making this the fastest to boil induction cooktop available. The KitchenAid 36-inch induction cooktop.
Now it's time for our community billboards brought to you by Pepsi and Cullman Jefferson Gas. Bailiton Head Start is taking applications for preschool services for children ages 3 through 5. Parents can call for an application 256-796-2834. And Smith Lake Park Memorial Day Festival will take place on Saturday, May the 24th from 9 until 4. There will be live music, it's free admission, arts and crafts, food vendors, golf cart and bike parade, prizes, swimming pool will be open, and putt-putt golf available. And the Lady Bearcat Basketball Camp will be held. Cullman High School is hosting a basketball camp for girls who completed the 2nd through 8th grades, June the 2nd through the 6th, from 8:30 until noon. The camp will include special guests, demonstrations, and breakout sessions to help the players. It's $100 for one player or $75 each for siblings. The VFW will host a Memorial Day program in Veterans Park at Sportsman's Lake on Saturday, May the 24th at 10. Those wishing to pay tribute to family members or friends lost in a war or to our fallen soldiers in general are invited and encouraged to come by and pay their respects. If you have a community billboard you'd like to share with us, you can email it to channel2cullman@gmail.com. Give us a call, 256-734-7399, or be a friend on Facebook, Channel 2 Cullman, and spell out the number 2. And we'd like to wish a happy birthday to Javin Stewart. And Javin will have be put into the drawing on Friday, where they have the possibility of winning an ice cream cake from Dairy Queen.
The weather forecast brought to you by Mitch Smith Chevrolet. Make the switch to Mitch. It will be a rainy, rainy afternoon. Maybe showers and thunderstorms today. Some possibly severe with a high of 75. 80% chance of more showers and thunderstorms tonight. Maybe some severe weather, low of 51. Rain ending tomorrow morning, then clearing off, but noticeably cooler tomorrow with a high of 63.
There's stuff around your house, but we don't make stuff. We make ovens. Dual fuel, double ovens. And they bake so evenly that now delicious is something you can depend on. We only make things for one room. The best room, your kitchen. We're devoted to it. And you can feel it in everything we make. Nobody knows the kitchen like KitchenAid.
Overwhelmed by home refinancing offers from telephone solicitors and direct mail advertising, and then find you're not qualified for a specific plan? The Mortgage Center, a hometown lender, compares the rates from all home loan lenders and the qualifications of the various government programs to find a plan best suited to you. The Mortgage Center helps Cullman County people purchase and refinance their homes.
This is Pat Moody. Call us today and let us tailor a loan program to your specific needs and requirements.
We have to be more responsive to the needs of victims within our community. And we will do this by establishing a victim service unit within the Sheriff's Office, utilizing the personnel there. This unit will also assist the victims of assault, domestic violence cases, to the needed people that they can speak to that will help them not only get self-help, but through the prosecution of their case. And I would like to ask for your vote on June 3rd in the 2014 Republican primary election.
At Premier Bank, we take pride in serving our community. We respect our customers, and we've won awards for our ethical conduct. We're motivated to do all we can for you, and we're interested in your banking needs. We're efficient, safe, and sound, and our relationships with our customers are second to none.
At Premier Bank, we put the customer first.
While Washington liberals like Obama and Pelosi continue to attack Alabama families and values, conservative leaders like Ed Henry are fighting back, championing pro-life legislation, standing strong against Obamacare, and keeping taxes low so we can create good jobs. Ed Henry, the conservative champion we need in Montgomery.
Good morning, and welcome to the 2014 Candidate Forum for the Republican Primary on June 3rd. Today we will be talking with candidates for the Associate Commissioner, Place 1 on the East Side. And the candidates are Darrell Hicks and Kerry Watson. We'll ask questions and we will rotate the beginning of the answers from each candidate. Our first question starts with Mr. Hicks. Roads are always the big issue in Cullman County. What changes, if any, do you propose for the Cullman County Road Department?
What we're looking at each day is trying to improve the efficiency of the road department. A few examples, we have combined the two road departments, East and West Road Department, a couple of years ago. And by doing so, we're using the same equipment all over the county, some of the personnel all over the county. And this has resulted in about $1 million savings to the taxpayers of Cullman County every year. And we're still continually looking at different ways. We spend a tremendous amount of money on bush hogging, mowing right-of-ways. We're trying to have a more aggressive spray program to cut down on the manpower hours as far as bush hogging goes. People don't realize how costly it is to run all the mowing equipment all through the summer. So if we can knock those weeds back and just get Bermuda grass growing, then we can handle that pretty easy. And I see right now that's going to be one of the biggest cost-saving things that we have going here to cut down on the expense, and we'll have a little extra money maybe to do a little bit more paving and maintenance of the roads. We're down to our budget is quite small. We've discussed that a number of times. You know, the road dollar is worth, gasoline tax dollar is worth 65 cents today what it was in the year 2000. And there is no increase in gasoline tax money coming in. And so we're having to implement ways every day to cut costs and be more efficient. And that's the only way that we can just kind of stay in the game and or stay ahead of the game.
Okay. Question now goes to Mr. Watson. What ideas do you have to save money from the road department?
I think we have to be proactive on our maintenance. As far as our road, getting the maintenance done on bush hogging and spraying. And I think we also need to, as far as ditches and stuff, get all that maintenance, because that way we're going to save more money because we don't have to do as much repairs on our roads. Our roads are deteriorating because of the drainage down the roads. I've talked to a retired state engineer from the State Highway Department, and he said that's one of the problems in Cullman County is our shoulders, that we don't keep the shoulders off and the ditches cleaned out, and keep the water running off in the ditches instead of the roads. So that would be a priority to me to get that, and I think that's going to save us money. And as Mr. Hicks has said, they're saving $1 million a year from combining the departments. So that's $4 million that we should have been spending on roads, if that's a fact.
Okay. All right. Our second question, we'll start with you, Mr. Watson.
question is, we all keep hearing a lot of talk about water rates and keeping the water rates as low as possible. Do you feel that large volume users should receive a discount, and the result of that would be that residential users would pay a higher per gallon fee?
I think we have to do something that's fair across the board. I think we need to look at the way they do it. Now, I think now there's a process where the more you use, you kind of get a discount or something. But we also got to think about our senior citizens that's on a fixed income. I mean, when you're on a fixed income and you don't get but $500 a month, we can't penalize those folks, because to them, $5, $10, $20, that can mean a meal. So I think we got to work as hard as we can to maintain and keep a fair rate across the board for everyone.
Okay. Mr. Hicks?
I feel like that the larger users of water should have a discount. Most water systems already provide this. If you pay your electric bill is the same way. The more electricity you use, the cheaper the rate that you get per kilowatt hour. That's kind of a common practice in most utilities. I don't expect a great increase in water rates. When you kind of look at the water now, a lot of it's kind of dependent on your individual water system. You know, we talk about the wholesale rates of water. You know, most systems, a minimum bill is $17 to $20 is a minimum bill on a couple thousand gallons of water. Well, the wholesale rate for a couple thousand gallons of water that the water system is purchasing from the utility board is going to cost you right now $4.02. So, you know, I think the water systems can help greatly in this by, you know, being more efficient with their systems. And so the wholesale rate is, even though it's going to go up some, you know, that's just a small portion of a person's water bill.
Okay. The third question is, everyone talks about wasteful government spending. What spending cuts can be made by the county commission? This question starts with Mr. Hicks.
Well, the example that I gave a while ago, you know, Mr. Watson said maybe we should have took that $1 million that we saved in the road department, spent on the roads. What was happening at that time, this million, the past commission was spending $1 to $2 million a year over budget, and that was being drained from the county reserves. Well, you know, when you got a reserve, you can only drain it so much. So basically what that done was stop the drain on the county reserves. And so, you know, the road department is still, it's hard to manage. And as far as maintenance goes, you know, maintenance is done every day. Ditching, you know, we've got almost 1,800 miles of roads in Cullman County. And when you start talking about ditching, you know, it takes a long time to get around as far as ditching goes. So, you know, money is a big problem, and as long as we have the second most miles of roads in the state of Alabama, and we're 16th in funding, it's going to be a tough project. And maintenance, you know, that's basically what our road department is. We're a maintenance department. You know, we're not road builders, and it was designed. You know, it was set up to be a maintenance program. And we keep a very detailed record every day on what money is spent on what road as far as maintenance goes, as far as labor, equipment, and materials. And this is how we determine, you know, which roads are going to be plowed up and repaved the next year, those roads that require the most maintenance, and also that has the most traffic on those roads.
And Mr. Watson, what ideas do you have about cutting wasteful government spending?
I think if anything, you need to sit down and when you get in there, look at the budget and see what things that you can work with. Because everybody's budget, even your home budget, there's things that you can work with and you can do a little less with. Vehicles, I think we need to look at as far as type style vehicles we're purchasing. I think a basic work truck would be a fine work truck for anyone to drive a daily work business. I think you can look at other things as far as maintenance of the buildings and stuff, see how we're doing stuff on that, make sure we're every dollar we're getting what our maximum out of it. So my thought would be on that, when you get in there, sit down and look over every number and make sure we're spending wisely on every account.
Okay. All right. We're going to take a commercial break, but want to remind you that today's forum is available for viewing on channel2cullman.com and on YouTube. Stay with us.
As a local auto owners independent agency, we are dedicated to assisting you in your time of need. We live and work right in your community, and we're available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Fortunately, emergencies don't happen every day, but when they do, we're here to personally see you through. For life, home, car, and business insurance, call us, your local independent auto owners agent today.
Overwhelmed by home refinancing offers from telephone solicitors and direct mail advertising, and then find you're not qualified for a specific plan? The Mortgage Center, a hometown lender, compares the rates from all home loan lenders and the qualifications of the various government programs to find a plan best suited to you. The Mortgage Center helps Cullman County people purchase and refinance their homes.
This is Pat Moody. Call us today and let us tailor a loan program to your specific needs and requirements.
Speaker Pro Audio and Video is your church sound, video, computer, and lighting system experts. We've been installing and servicing these systems for almost 30 years. We've worked with small churches, large churches, and all those in between. We handle all major brands like Mackey, Crown, JBL, PV's Architectural Acoustics, EAW, Shure, DBX, Behringer, and Audio Technica, just to name a few. We have a full service repair shop and free evaluation and estimates. So give us a call today and we'll get the job done.
Wells Turner Family Pharmacy is a proud supporter of local city and county athletics. You can keep your money right here in Cullman because Wells Turner Family Pharmacy is locally owned and operated. At Wells Turner, you won't have to wait long to get your prescriptions filled, but while you're here, you can send a package by UPS, buy a gift from the gift shop, pay your phone bill, or develop your photos using our DKS photo kiosk. Wells Turner Family Pharmacy. We are a Health Mart community pharmacy.
Hello and welcome back to the 2014 Candidate Forum for the Republican Primary on June 3rd. The candidates for Associate Commissioner Place One are who we're talking with today, and we'll continue questions. The fourth question, we'll start with Mr. Watson. Some candidates are talking about better accountability in the commission office, and what ideas do you have about improving accountability?
I think accountability starts at the top. I think we've got to show people our accountability. I think we need to have I would like to do like a quarterly letter mail out to the residents or just post it on our line online. I think we got the county has a online on the internet, and I'd like to post it on there just to give everybody a heads up what we're doing, what we're planning to do, and what's going on and what we have done for at the road department all the way through every office. That way people's got view and it's open. It's not like you don't know what's going on in the county, and I think that's going to put some accountability on the commissioners all the way down to all the employees. And that's where I would like to start as far as accountability.
Okay. And Mr. Hicks, what ideas do you have about accountability?
Well, we already have a web page that we post, you know, what's going on and with the road department. And a lot of the activities, you know, that are going on as far as the commission goes, you know, we have a work session every 2 weeks before the commission meetings, and these are open meetings for people to attend. And of course, the commission meetings are open to the public, and we invite anyone to come by to attend either the work session or the commission meeting or both. Sometimes the meetings are well attended, and you know, sometimes they're not. But each time that we meet, the newspaper is there. The press is always invited, and they're there most of the time, and they report on the activities, you know, that the commission actions that they take. It's published in the paper, I think, every time we meet, you know, exactly the agenda that we had that day and what action was taken in a commission meeting. And we have I'll speak for all the commissioners that we have now. We have a very open door policy. As I've said before, my door is always open. I don't even have a key to my office. And there, oftentimes, a lot of people, you know, stop by, particularly in the mornings, and when we're there, and you know, ask questions, and they're able to stop by anytime, you know, and talk to their commissioners. A lot of times in the afternoons, if we don't have something pushing there at the office, you know, we spend time, you know, out in the communities and visiting with folks. And I try to attend all kind of public events, and you know, I get a lot of feedback at public events when you're out. You know, people are talking to you, and so we try to be very accessible to the public. And phone calls, the best of my knowledge, every phone call that I've had in the last 4 years, I have returned that phone call. And if action is required, then I do a follow-up to see if the people are satisfied with the problem that they had.
Okay. Our fifth question involves major purchases of the county. The question is, should the purchase always go to the lowest bidder, or should county businesses be given a preference? And this question will start with you.
Well, you've got to follow the law. You know, if anything's over $15,000, it has to be bid. There is provisions in the bid law that if a local bid does not exceed 3%, then by law you're allowed to accept that local bid. But if it's greater than 3%, you can't accept it. You have to go with a low bidder. You know, they told us that, and oftentimes when you bid a project, you may not get the best buy. And I asked that one time to the ACCA, the Association of County Commissioners, and they said that the bid law was put in place not to save you money. It was put in place to keep you honest. And you have these strict guidelines that you have to follow, and I adhere to those. I'm too old to go to jail, so that's just the way the state bid law is.
Mr. Whiteson, what ideas do you have about the question of should the purchase always go to the lowest bidder, or should county businesses be given a preference?
As Mr. Hicks said, you have to go by the law on that, and the state sits that, so you would have to abide by that. I'm younger than Mr. Hicks, but I still don't want to go to jail. But I would abide by the law, and it's anytime possible that we could use a local vendor or whatever, I would try my best for, you know, using, but it would be based on the law and the bid law.
Is the alternative to put it back out for bid if the bids come in?
Well, yeah, if you think the bid is excessive, you can always reject the bid and advertise the bid again. And we've done that numerous times. And, you know, sometimes we only get one bid. We think it's a little high. Well, you know, we reject that bid and put it out and hopefully get bids from some additional bids in. some of the projects where there's it's less than $15,000 that does not have to go out to bid, then yes, those are, I won't say 99.9% of the time, are local business.
Okay. You kind of feel the same
way? Yeah, that's the way I would agree with that.
Our last question, we'll start with you, Mr. Watson. The cost of health insurance for county employees continues to grow and may be getting much larger. How do you recommend that be addressed, and should it be discontinued with the employees applying with the Affordable Care Act exchanges?
I feel like our employees are important, and the pay with the county is not the best in the world. You know, I mean, everybody, it's a good living, but it's not the best. Several people have to work two jobs to make a living, and that's one of our benefits that keeps us with good workers is the insurance. I think as much as we can, we need to do the best we can to absorb some of that to keep these employees, because it's hard to find good employees, and Cullman County is lucky. We've got some good employees. So as one of their benefits, I think we need to do everything possible to help them with that insurance to keep them here so we don't have a high turnover. Because when you get a high turnover, that's going to cost the county more money because you're going to be retraining and trying to get people back into those positions. So I think we should do everything possible to maintain the insurance we have now. We're actually a self-insured, and it's the right underwriter written by Blue Cross of Alabama.
And Mr. Hicks?
Yes, Cullman County employees, we are self-insured. Blue Cross Blue Shield just simply administers the program for us. And the employees of Cullman County have a good insurance policy. I'm a retired teacher and on teacher hospital insurance. And I'll say that the county employees have a better insurance policy than I do. And it's been a kind of a major concern the 4 years I've been in. It's no secret that the cost of insurance has increased. And one thing that we've been able to do as a commission, we have not passed on these increases to our employees. We have absorbed the increase ourselves. We have not raised copay and or cut any benefits. So this was kind of our pledge to the employees that we would do the best that we could to provide them with good benefits. And you know, that's I think that's the main job of a commissioner, is looking at that budget and making sure that the employees get their paycheck every 2 weeks, that they receive their benefits, and that we provide materials and equipment for them to do a good job. And that's my number one concern as a commissioner, that we provide those resources right there for our employees.
Okay. We're going to take another commercial break, but we want you to stay with us. We'll have closing remarks from the candidates for Associate Commissioner Place 2. Thank you.
MakerPro Audio and Video has the video security systems to cover all of your home and business concerns. Wired, wireless, indoor or out, we've got you covered. Standard and high-def cameras, day and night vision, and remote pan-tilt zoom cameras are also available. Whether you need a small 4-camera system or a larger 30-camera system, we've got the one you need. Remote viewing from your home computer, smartphone, and iPad is also available. Whether home or business, call MakerPro Audio and Video today for your free quote. 256-739-0388.
Wells Turner Family Pharmacy is a proud supporter of local city and county athletics. You can keep your money right here in Cullman because Wells Turner Family Pharmacy is locally owned and operated. At Wells Turner, you won't have to wait long to get your prescriptions filled, but while you're here, you can send a package by UPS, buy a gift in the gift shop, pay your phone bill, or develop your photos using our DKS photo kiosk. Wells Turner Family Pharmacy, We are a Health Mart community pharmacy.
Overwhelmed by home refinancing offers from telephone solicitors and direct mail advertising, and then find you're not qualified for a specific plan? The Mortgage Center, a hometown lender, compares the rates from all home loan lenders and the qualifications of the various government programs to find a plan best suited to you. The Mortgage Center helps Cullman County people purchase and refinance their homes.
This is Pat Moody. Call us today and let us tailor a loan program to your specific needs and requirements.
As a local auto owner's independent agency, we are dedicated to assisting you in your time of need. We live and work right in your community, and we're available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Fortunately, emergencies don't happen every day, but when they do, we're here to personally see you through. For life, home, car, and business insurance, call us, your local independent auto owner's agent today.
Welcome back to the 2014 Candidate Forum for the Republican primary on June 3rd. We're talking today with the candidates for Associate Commissioner Place 1 on the east side, and we'll now have their closing comments. And we will begin with Mr. Hicks.
Thank you, and thank you for this opportunity to visit with everyone. I have served as the County Commissioner Place 1 for the past 4 years. I've enjoyed this last 4 years. I feel like I have been able to make a contribution to make Cullman County a little bit better. We have been very frugal with your tax dollars, yet we have tried to meet the needs of the citizens of Cullman County. We're not where we would like to be, but I think that we have made a lot of progress. Not one of the things that I am most proud of is the unity that we have shared as a commission. We don't always agree entirely on every issue, but as gentlemen, we sit down and we discuss the issues, and at the end of the day, we try to come out united. And that's one thing that I'm really proud of. We have developed a good relationship with the city of Cullman, the different municipalities in the county, and are working with those. As I have mentioned times before, there's been projects that the city could not do by themselves, nor we could do by ourselves, but working together, we've been able to tackle some really big projects, and those projects are soon going to be coming to fruition, and this is one of the reasons that I'm seeking re-election, is I would like to stay on that same track, see these projects finished, and we have some other big projects in the planning there that we would like to kind of get off the ground. And it takes a while to accomplish a lot of these big projects. I know the ATRIP program that we're participating in now, we're going to be getting about 70 miles of new asphalt roads, and it's going to cost us 20% of the cost because it's an 80-20 match. This is something that we started working on way over 2 years ago, and right now the majority of those bids are going to be let by the state this summer, and you know, the paving really won't get started, you know, until in the fall of the year. So there's a lot of long-term things that takes a while for you to work on, and I think that's been one of the problems. And as far as the county commission is, we turn over the commission too often. You know, when you change the face of the commission every 2 years, it's kind of hard to stay focused, and for commissioners to stay focused and stay on the same track and path to get some of these big things accomplished. You know, as far as the roads and things like that, it most of those are long-term projects, you know, that you have to work on. So it takes several years to get some of these things done. And so this is, you know, one of the reasons that I am seeking re-election, so that we can continue to move forward. I think we've made a lot of progress. Yes, we still got a long ways to go, but we work hard at it every day to improve conditions, make government more efficient, more accountable, and to give more benefits to the taxpayers of Cullman County.
Okay, thank you. And closing remarks from Mr. Kerry Watson.
The reason I would ask you to vote for me is that I'm going to be a working commissioner that's going to be out and about in this county, that you'll see me out working in the office and out in the county. I'm going to be hands-on. I'm going to be someone that's going to be available at all times. I'm going to work 24 hours a day for you to try to do things that benefit our county. I love the county of Cullman. I was a deputy 16 years, and I worked with the sales tax office, and I love serving the people of Cullman County. And I see this as another way to serve the great people of this county to continue in service. When I entered this race, I had no agenda, and I still have no agenda but one, and that's to be fair across the board and treat everybody equally in this county and work hard for you. So on June the 3rd, I would ask for your vote for Kerry Watson, Place 1 County Commission, to be your voice for our county. Thank you.
Thank you. Again, this has been the 2014 Candidate Forum for the Republican primary on June the 3rd. We've been talking with the Associate Commissioner candidates for Place 1. I want to remind you that today's forum is available for viewing on Channel2Cullman.com and on YouTube. And we also invite you to join us again on Friday as we will speak with the candidates for the Cullman County Sheriff's Office. Thank you and have a good day.